Beethoven had never before played as he played that night for the young girl who could not see. From the moment that his fingers touched the keys, the very tone of the instrument seemed to grow sweeter. Both the brother and the sister, they were silent with wonder. The young man laid aside his work and the girl sat perfectly still to listen to Beethoven's music. She leaned forward a little so that she would not miss a single note of the sweet music. Suddenly, the flame of the candle wavered here means became weak and unsteady, sank, flickered here means kept going on and off as it burned, and went out. Beethoven paused for a while. His friend rose quietly and threw open the shutters. Shutters here means the window. The soft moonlight filled the room so that it was almost as bright as before. The moon beams fell brightest upon the harpsichord and the player. After the music stopped, the young man arose. Eagerly, yet shyly, he approached the musician. "Wonderful," he said in a low tone and started appreciating to Beethoven. One of the composer's rare smiles flitted across his face. Flitted here means he smiled lightly and quickly. "Listen," he said, and with a master's touch he played the opening bars of his sonata in F. The girl immediately understood that no one but the composer of the music could have played it so well and perfectly. She then exclaimed, "Are you Beethoven?" Beethoven rose to go, but they begged him to stay. "Play to us once more, only once more," they started saying to Beethoven. He again seated himself. The moonlight shone brightly through the window. Looking up thoughtfully at the sky and stars, he said, "I will compose a sonata to the moonlight." Touching the keys lightly, he began to play a sad and lovely melody. The music filled the room as gently as the soft moonlight creeps over the dark earth. Then the music became brighter and more rapid. No one seemed to see the moon gliding through the clouds. Instead, one thought of sprites and fairies dancing merrily together. Sprites here refers to the small creatures with magical powers or supernatural elements. Once again, the music changed and the notes were as rapid as before, but they seemed filled with sadness. It was music that filled the heart with wonder. "Farewell to you," said Beethoven, pushing back his chair when he was done and turning towards the door. "Will you come again?" both the brothers and the sister asked in one breath. Beethoven paused and looked tenderly at the girl. "Yes, yes," he said, "I will come again and give you some lessons. Farewell. I will come again soon." "Let us hasten," said Beethoven to his friend. Hasten means to go fast. Because he wanted to write out that sonata while the music was still in his mind. When they reached home, Beethoven seated himself at once and began to compose the music. He worked until daybreak, and when he had finished, he had written the Moonlight Sonata.